Good morning again for those of you who are at City Hall for the flag raising. I'm aware of the cold temperature, so we'll try and keep this as brief as possible. Thank you all very much for coming on such a miserable day, or lovely day, except that it's cold. I'm going to ask Father Brian Harrington to give us a benediction to set this day off on its proper course. Father?
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Loving God, look kindly upon us who have gathered to lay this wreath of remembrance, honoring our loved ones who left family and home in Ireland, crossed the waters, to begin a new life here in New Bedford for themselves and for us, their children. Having crossed over the waters of death, may they know joy and peace in that one true home that truly lasts forever. And as we celebrate your servant Patrick, we ask your blessings upon the people of Ireland, with whom we unite ourselves, and certainly Irish people everywhere. Bless us who have gathered to remember. May our lives reflect and symbolize what this Celtic cross symbolizes, our love and faith in you, and our love for all your people. This we ask through the intercession of Mary, Our Lady of Knock, of Patrick, your servant, as we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Father. I'll now ask our Mayor, Mr. Jon Mitchell, to please say a few secular words of greeting. Thank you.
Thank you, Paul. I can. I don't have to be all secular. God bless everybody today. It's a separation of church and state to a point. Father Harrington, great to see you today. Thanks for coming out. And everybody, long time no see. It's been all of about 45 minutes or so. This is one of my favorite monuments in the city. And again, at the risk of sounding partial towards the Irish, it's a special place, and it offers an opportunity for reflection here on our city's waterfront. So many of the Irish, both the one boaters and the two boaters, were part of our fishing fleet, including my relatives, and this is a great place to sit and reflect not only on the monument but also our seafaring community. It's a poignant place also to consider, you know, the tremendous contributions that Irish Americans all over the United States and especially here have had over the years in our nation's armed forces. The Americans of Irish descent have distinguished themselves in every branch of the military and right up through our current wars. And that's something to be proud of and something to think about right here at our monument. I also just, again, want to thank the Friendly Sons for all the work they've done in keeping up this monument. We help out as a city, but the real love comes from this group. And it's really another place in the city that every New Bedfordite, regardless of ethnicity, can be proud of. And once again, I thank the Friendly Sons for all their hard work in making this such a great weekend, not only through the flag raisings and the mass and the dinner dance, but also the half marathon, which is really becoming a tremendous opportunity for the city to showcase all the great things that it has going on. So thank you very much. Have a great weekend this weekend. It's going to be a great weekend despite the cold weather. And I look forward to seeing you at the other events.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. Now, the sequence of events next is we will raise the Irish flag and the American flag. And then finally, Tim Nelson, our Vice President, and myself will place the wreath at the foot of the Celtic cross. So,
I'm ready.
We did the American flag first then.
The Irish flag first then. Oh, let me just check it.
Well, I think it's number. this need to. Beautiful.
Nope, wrong one, sorry.
Well, at least we know the words. It's hard to see.
Can you see?
I got it.
Great timing, and thank you, Jay Costa, one of our board members. And now for the American flag, I will call upon another board member and a veteran of the United States Navy, Bill O'Brien. Now introduce a representative of Congressman William Keating, who can't be with us at this time, but somebody will speak for him.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Thank you all for inviting us here today. I'll be very brief. If the cold doesn't keep our speeches short, the Irish Wolfhound looming so close to the podium certainly will. I just want to say on behalf of Congressman Keating, we're glad to be here today. We're glad to take part in all these weekend's festivities. It's so important to mark, obviously, the occasion of St. Patrick's, Feast of St. Patrick, but also to remember those who have gone on to a better place, and that's what we're really here, all here for today. So without further ado, thank you very much, and best of luck and great weekend for all the members and all the residents of New Bedford who will be taking part in these celebrations this weekend. Thank you very much.
That, ladies and gentlemen, brings our brief dedication of the wreath at the monument to a close. I'm very grateful to you all for showing up on such a cold afternoon. Thank you all, and we'll see you at Mass tomorrow morning and at the dinner tomorrow evening, I hope. Thank you all.
Thank you.